Okay. First of all, let me say this. No slander. The song is A+. And don't take my tone as anything other than that. The song's tremendous. But I just have a question as we open the show today. Is this really like who we are? Is this what we're going to be? Just so I understand, okay? What I watched last night, and then what I have listened to and read and seen since, I feel like I don't belong here. I feel like I exist on a different planet. This is where we are now. Mm-hmm. We are needing a wild, desperate, unbelievable comeback against garbage in order to simply not be eliminated. In order not to clinch a playoff spot. Not to win a series. God forbid not to put us back in the Stanley Cup Finals in a place that I'm told is Hockey Town. The original six. The original six franchise. The greatest American hockey franchise ever. And I'm sitting here listening to callers all day. And people, you know, you'll have to pardon me. I was so disgusted by being down 4-1 to that ass known as the Montreal Canadiens. That is a bad hockey team. It's a daycare center filled with kids. They had a guy who was in college 10 minutes ago. I'm pretty sure he played in a Frozen Four last weekend. He's up with the club. I was so angry after being down 4-1 because I, unlike most of these people, and certainly the TV broadcast, I have standards. Mm-hmm. You know what I wanted the Wings to do last night? Come out and obliterate this team.
You wanted them to have the 4-1 lead.
I wanted blood. Yeah. I wanted them to actually do what they did in Toronto, sort of, before they blew the lead. And I sat here and I'm going, wow. These people are celebrating like they're in. Mm-hmm. Or celebrating like something big. No, all you did was earn the right to now have to win tonight and turn a trick on the corner to get in.
You earned one more day.
No, you earned one more day and you have to beg for help.
Yeah.
Like that's, I don't celebrate that. And I understand if you watch the game and you're pumped you won, fine. There was a woman they showed in the crowd. She was making a face like she was giving birth. Mm-hmm. It was like a religious experience.
Mm-hmm. Buddy.
Is this what we are?
It is. It is. I can help you with this. This is what happens when it's been so long since you've had a winner in this town. You can call yourself Hockey Town. You can call yourself whatever. But when you haven't won in a while, like it or not, standards fall. You walk into the bar of the club at 10 o'clock, you have higher standards. By 2 o'clock, standards are not the same. At 2 o'clock, you'll take a strong 5.5 because, well, beats nothing. And that's what we were last night. Beats nothing. We get an extra day. We got a little bit of hope left. Yes, we got a scoreboard watch. We got to win the game. But that's where we are because it's been a while. When the Pistons have played in a playoff series at the LCA and you haven't, that's a problem. And that's where we are. So that's why you saw that. I'm not agreeing with it. I'm not saying it's right.
No.
But you have to understand people. And so, yes, for Detroiters, for that comeback, because it looked like all was lost.
Because they were lifeless.
And then they throw two octopus on the ice, and
stop.
All of a sudden,
stop with that.
You get rejuvenated.
No, I can't. Look, am I happy I have something to watch tonight? Of course I am. But when once you're down 4-1 to an awful team, when you have everything to play for, you've angered me to a point. I don't have jubilation in my body.
Well, you know why? Because it looks like you don't want it. You had to go back and take it from Montreal, but you didn't come out like a team that wanted to be in the playoffs.
Correct.
You didn't come out with a team who said, you know what? This is the final home game here in Detroit. Guys,
let's put on a show.
We got to do this, okay? Forget about what happened all in the season. Forget about the Arizona games. It's all about tonight. Let's start it off. Let's get the first goal. Let's get the second goal. Let's just beat these bums. It shouldn't have been what it was. Now you take the victory, but for everybody who was there, everybody
that's
was
the
sitting
loudest
in the arena.
That arena's ever been.
It was. And they were sitting there all thinking, I can't believe it's over. And then, wait, it's 4-3. Well, maybe if we can get a goal, if we can at least get a point. And then Raymond scores with, what, like 27 seconds left. You get the point. Okay. Could we win this thing? He shoots. He scores. They win. You get this great opening. Yes. Is the bar low? Absolutely.
Okay. Then just call your call the people what they are. Just say it. If you lower your bar to that level, you're a loser. Straight up.
Or you're hungry.
No, this is
or
not,
you're hungry, Mike.
No, this isn't the Arizona Coyotes. Maybe the problem is I hold the teams in this town to the same standard I hold my own. I view the Red Wings as one of the elite franchises in the history of hockey. I view them as the New York Yankees of hockey, okay? It's an unbelievable tradition. It's an unbelievable—I mean, the logo itself, it's Americana. This is a town where the Stanley Cup is the goal. To sell—the idea—look, what offends me is the idea that we are in this needing help after being 9 points above the cut line 5 weeks ago. And I'm watching mm-hmm. this team with everything to play for, Rico. If we forgot everything else that transpired mm-hmm. to get here, mm-hmm. I was sitting in disbelief watching this game last night down 4-1 yeah. to an atrocious hockey team.
Right.
So at that point...
Right, it wasn't 4-1 to Boston. It wasn't 4-1 to a top. This was, yeah, it was Montreal. You should have just came out there, blown their doors off, and ready to hop on a flight to go back and do it again.
Or just not be down 4-1. You know, things happen in a hockey game. Maybe you're tied at 1, you're down 2-1, and you got to, okay. When you're down 4-1, you've put some of the worst tape of your season on the ice. You have. It's And I'm just in shock listening in mornings and middays and then just forget about the media coverage. Well, and I'm going, we still could win tonight and get left out.
What you wanted to see is the way the Wings played in the final minutes and in overtime for the entire game. Why didn't you start that way where every possession counted, where all of a sudden you just saw the grit and the determination? You didn't see that at the beginning of the game, but you saw desperation kick in. This team should be better than desperation. That should have just been Red Wing hockey out there. But instead, it took, guys, we're about 2 minutes away from cleaning
17.
Out our lockers.
Minute 17.
Yeah.
And again, my issue is I still am left as a fan. I have to sit here now and beg for help. That's how bad they were down the stretch. I got to beg for help. Yeah. Oh, well, if the Flyers do this and if they go, oh, well, what happens if we go to overtime and they go? Here's an idea. You could have handled your own business. But I'm just blown away. And look, you see it all over the place. Here's my fear. My fear is a great many people actually don't care what happens tonight. That they already think the season's a success. See, I think what we're going to get is a lot of the revisionist history. Where, let's say the Wings win and the Caps win.
See, I was about to say, let me meet you halfway. Because if the Wings win, I do agree with you. They'll say, we were that close.
Yeah, we were in a chase.
Eichmann has us standing there at the edge of the, looking at the playoffs. Where, man, next year.
Whereas I look at it, you utterly collapsed and put yourself in this spot. And it takes away any vibes we had February 28th.
That would be the other side of the coin, yes.
I would really like to explore it, talk to the people about it, and just see where they're at. What? Is the season a success no matter what happens tonight? Is that where we've arrived at in this town? A participation trophy? And mind you, making the playoffs really isn't that big of a deal in hockey. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, not. Like, it's kind of something that after 5 years I expected. You know what I don't like? I don't like the fact that this game... I need help. I don't like the fact that with everything on the line, they showed their ass for the better part of two-thirds of a hockey game. And yet, they score the goal, and it's this all-is-forgiven routine that I just can't vibe with.
Right.
Because my goal is I want to see Stanley Cup again. And I'm sorry, Rico, since February 28th, all they had to do in any of these games, forget about, well, they cooled off. Buddy, if you show up against Arizona once and steal one singular point, are we in this spot? No, we are not. I have a very hard time celebrating. And after 4-1?
No,
you owed me winning that game. That's not anything I'm going to, you know, pop a hole in my denim for. Well,
it's the conversation I had with Rieger this morning. I'm like, Rieger, if they beat Arizona one time, last night everybody's celebrating, you're going to the playoffs. You clinched the spot. You're in. But when you haven't had teams in the playoffs for so long, you start off with high standards. They eventually erode away. The clock is ticking. You're like, man, it's been a while. That's why people treated the Lions that way.
So I'm weird.
Imagine if the Tigers just make one of the last wild card spot. We're excited. If the Pistons are the 10th seed in the play-in game, this town would go crazy. Why? It hasn't even been mediocre. It's been substandard. It's been absolute garbage water for everything. That's why everybody bows down to Brad Holmes, because he brought a winner here.
Yeah, but Brad was literally a quarter from a Super Bowl now.
But he took a team that at one point was sitting there at 1-6, and it looked like, oh my God.
But the point I'm making is this, and I know we're over, so just hold on. I'll save it. 248-539-9797. No, David. No.